All new at 10, it has happened again. For the second time this week, someone's been attacked responding to an ad on Craigslist. Tonight, police are looking for two men who fired round after round at a family. The family thought they were meeting a woman and her son to buy a car at a home in Raleigh around 11 this morning.
But instead, two men tried robbing them. One family member was shot while trying to get away. He was taken to the hospital. WREG's Jessica Gertler is live tonight. Jessica, is he okay?
Well, doctors say he'll be fine. He was shot in the shoulder. But imagine this. You take your mom to buy a car. You're sitting there waiting for the seller to show up. And then all of a sudden, you start to get a funny feeling. You notice a car continuously circling the block with a black T-shirt just like this, dangling from the back, hiding the license plate. What happens next is unsettling. A family anxiously waited in this driveway on Quintel around 11 this morning. A man says he and his girlfriend drove his mom 2 hours to buy a car she saw on Craigslist. The seller told them he'd knock off $1,500, even claimed he was a cop just to make them feel safe. Turns out they were anything but.
No, it's a big lot. It's on the corner. You can't see nobody coming from the back.
Dwayne Hampton lives in this house but wasn't home when police say two men came from his backyard and demanded the family's money. The pair opened fire as the family threw the car in reverse, hitting a brick column.
They destroyed the column there, and they backed up, and they were shot in the arm.
The family drove to Walgreens on Stage Road and called police, alarming many in this Raleigh neighborhood.
It's none of this going on close by where you are. Doesn't feel safe at all.
As for Dwayne, he can't figure out why his home was the center of a crime scene. He says another family showed up to his house the day before, too.
Someone came yesterday asking about a car, and my wife just through the door, she told them there was no car for sale, and they kind of lingered, and then she called the police.
Tonight, he's questioning his safety at his own home.
Now I got to look over my shoulder when I, you know, come out to the garage or the driveway.
And we reached out to that family several times but never heard back. Police tonight still trying to put the pieces together, but the homeowner is adamant that he or anyone at his house had no role in this crime. Live in the medical district, Jessica Gertler, WREG News Channel 3.